request our first speaker of today's convention, Dr. Lingaraj Sahoo, distinguished professor of IIT Guwahati of the Department of Bioscience and Bioengineering, and his research area is biofuel. He is having more than 70 scientific publications in different distinguished journals of the world.
Esteemed guests, Gaurav ji, Gibani ji, and Professor Subrata, and my friends here. At this outset, I would like to thank the organizers to bring me here at Hyderabad, all technocrats and all professionals sitting over here. Dada introduced me as a professor of IIT Guwahati and maybe teaching in some universities in Japan. You have seen the external accomplishments of mine. You have seen the name, the fame, you have read out the positions and the glorified success story. But it is I know that I don't deserve that. When you look back what I have gone through, lots of fears of failures, the voices of anxieties, and the pain of sorrows, and the glorifications of my jealousiness to my people around me, I don't see them succeeding in life or in professions. And then the sufferings that emanated from that, and it continued. I'm sure many of you must have gone through that, even now, in your professions. A lot of challenges. While overcoming them, every day you try to wage a war against those conflicts that comes from within, the biggest challenges in your life. And it continued, notwithstanding my birth at the holiest place, the Puri, to Lucknow, the Bada Imam Bada and Chota Imam Bada. Everywhere I tried to search the God. I found the God is sleeping in the rock. He is not helping me to awaken, to fight against my own difficulties. And then searching for living God. And one fine morning, I was searching for a shelter to regain my confidence, to control the desperations that I am going through, to get rid of the internal worries, to control the complexities that I am fighting with, and the resisting evils that is coming from my mind. I tried, nowhere I found the living God. I found the God sleeping in the rock. He's trying to convey me something, but I'm trying to get what he tries to convey me. I could not read the messages of God. Everywhere the God is sleeping. And one fine day, through someone, it's maybe a coincidence you say, or a miracle, I got to know there is a living God. And then the first time I got chance to visit Devaghar. Truly, I have never seen Thakur Ankur Chandra in my eyes. I have never seen. The first time I got the holy name through a coincidence in Bhubaneswar, I bought all the books. I thought I would read. Probably I got the answers, the ways to fight against my inner complexities. No. You need an inner force to read those books. Sometimes I read for a moment, for a day, you get peace. But then again, you come back to the natural challenges that you go through every day. I went to Devagar. And a lot of inquisitiveness. Maybe I will find the living God there. And I was traveling by a train. I decided to travel by a train from Guwahati to Devagar. Probably, I will not disclose the name. I had a co-passenger with me. He was also traveling to Devagar. And he said, he started sharing his experience. He said, do you know, he looks like an army major general. It's very well physique. And he said, do you know, I work for ULFA. Have you heard of ULFA? It's a terrorist organization which was working for liberating Assam, ULFA. He was the right hand of Paresh Barua, the chief of ULFA. And he said, I was in the hit list number 2 after Paresh Barua. And then once the army cordoned me in a place in Assam, an interior place in Assam, and they were almost about to fire me, maybe just 100 or 200 meter distance. They were chasing me, and having no way, when I got to know that I am surrounded by army in a village, almost they were narrowing me down, then I was lost. I could see my life is going to end. And the sins that I have committed, I was thinking maybe I don't have opportunity to leave more. Then he ran away. Suddenly it was about to sunset, and he found some people assembled with some white clothes, uniforms, and it was a satsang temple in a remote village in Assam, in Sonitpur district. And he went and sneaked into this crowd. And the moment army arrived there and said about to start the combing operations, and then the prayer starts. And what a coincidence. The prayer started, he got into those crowd, sat inside, and palpitating, his palpitations going on. The prayer got over. And then somehow, once the prayer got over, he got into those crowd, they went inside, preaching and something, the next processes. And then finally the army came inside, started searching everywhere. And one pujari, the priest, he said, you have come here to get the shelter, and Thakur ji will save you. And he had no idea how he get saved. And he was hided in a utensils, big utensils used for mass eating. He was hiding. There was many such utensils. The army knocked every nest utensils with a gun. And with the noise, they could hear if somebody is inside or not. Only one utensil still left, and that was where he was inside. Then they were suspicious. This man has come inside. How come he can get out? They waited for 1 day, 2 day, 3 day, and he stayed there inside. And then the satsang is there in the temple. They said, you can live here only when you perform, you do some duties to the God. And what is the duty? You have to clean the premises with a jhadu. Oh, jhadu lagane lage. So, and he stayed there for 1 month. And finally, after 1 month, the army left that place. And it was the first time. And he was so eager. If God can save me, why don't I see the living God? And on the advices, he went to Devagar. He said, if I would like to have every day like this life-saving day, what should I do? They said, you have to take a holy name. He went to the living God, Achajadev Sisi Dada, the third incarnations of Thakur Ankur Chandra ji, who you see at Devagar. And then he said, I would like to take the holy name. He said, you have to serve Thakur ji for consecutive 3 months. If you succeed, then I will give you the holy name. And now the same person, his name is removed from the hit list. We don't know how. And he is a priest. He looks after a satsang temple in one of the places in Assam. That's how my inquisitiveness increased. And then I was about to arrive in Devagar. When I entered, it was a serene atmosphere. I could see from a long distance one godly man sitting on a bed, and then and that's how I would see. I would like to share how I started removing my worries. The first thing I did, I saw many people are offering. I also went. I opened my purse. The first thing came a 100 rupees notes. Then I thought, oh, why I offer 100 rupees? It's just offering. Then I took out a coin and offered. And then there was a lot of crowd. I sat there, spent whole day. In the night, one of my co-passengers who went from Assam, he called me. He said, can you come to the main ashram? So I rushed there. I said, what happened? Then Acharyadev asked me, how is that visitor who has come with you? I thought, how did he know me? Then that co-passenger told, he asked, how is the professor who came from Guwahati? Did he like this place? Yes, of course he liked it. Next, what does he think? Can he give anything to God? Everything is given to him by God. So does he think that giving 1 rupee coin or 100 rupees note, can he, his offerings will be complete? Never. I was surprised. How come in a weak crowd, and the first thing I got to know, this money is just a symbolic thing. You cannot offer anything to the God. Everything is given to us by Him. And the journey started. I spent 2 days, 3 days there. And then the first incident happened. I took the holy name, and then I was told that you have to meditate. You have to meditate reciting the holy name. The holy name which embodies the Thakur Ankul Chandra's. I used to do a lot of meditations at the beginning. And sometimes you get peace for a moment. Next time you get lost in the world beyond the boundary of your imaginations. You feel a weightlessness. Probably if you do only meditations, you achieve that. But that was an incompleteness. I didn't find any answer to that. I was so curious, impatience. I came back to Guwahati. I practiced for the next 1 month. I thought, I took the holy name. Probably I didn't find the ways to the solutions. And at that time, the fourth incarnation, Pujini Babaji had come to Guwahati. And then I was so impatient. I thought, I'll go and ask. Everyone was asking. They had a queue. They were asking whatever questions there in their mind. I was about to ask. I could not stop myself. I was about to ask. The next moment I was thinking there was an audience. What they would think that this guy is asking. I took holy name. I didn't get anything. You will not believe. It went beyond my tolerance. I jumped. The moment I jumped, I was about to ask, suddenly one man rushed inside. Maybe a tribal man. He came rushing and he went flat in front of Pujaniya Babaji. Told exactly after the same questions. Humne to diksha liya, humare to kuch ummati nahi hua. I said, how come this guy asked the same questions I was about to ask? I said, at least I was safe. I was not embarrassed if I would have asked. The next moment, Babaji told, how do you, with a calm, loving voice, how do you wash clothes? He said, I put clothes, dirty clothes in a bucket with water and some detergent, and then I keep it for some time, half an hour, 1 hour, I wash, and then I open the tap, so the clean water falls inside, and then after some time, the dirty water goes outside. And the moment he finished his answer, Vajra told, our heart is like that. You have lots of anxieties, lots of sorrows, sufferings inside, conflicts, indecisions, and so much. The moment you take a holy name, the good things come inside. And if you have patience, you keep continuing that. So for someone, it may take few moments. For someone, it may take few days. Maybe for someone like me, it may take few more weeks. But eventually, you'll get that. What? the moment your bucket, your heart is full of clean things, then you start receiving the signal. And your mind gets calm, and your every decision will be correct. I tell you how I started experimenting on that. Being an atheist, I started experimenting everything that I was told by satsangis. I had a friend, my childhood friend, he worked for L&T Finance. He was a chief head of three divisions in India, L&T Finance. He said, look, when I recruit my IIM graduates, oh, I said, what do you ask? He said, we normally ask, I read their minds, because in 5 minutes you cannot judge a candidate. I read their mind. Oh, really? You can read mind? He said, but many times you fail to read the mind, so eventually you have to shunt out those candidates after they work for some time. Because when you have a client, and he's seeking a loan of 50 crores for his business, all the documents are perfect, you have to think his, to judge his mind, and that too in a fraction of a second. And he said, we got lots of failures in judging people, and then we have much, our company, many times we have deciding the wrong investments. It continued, and then I said, look, I was going through exactly the similar thing. So the judging mind and the decision making is the most important thing in your life. So I had one of our student in computer science, Vaibhav Gupta from Kanpur. He came with a similar incident. He was doing M.Tech in computer science. He got a job in ISRO, and he was dwindling what to do. Either to accept the job or to continue his studies. So everyone told you, I told you continue your studies, and the families told you join the job. And it so happened, he came, I told you, asked the living God. He came in a queue and asked, Bhagavad, at this moment, whatever you think, that's going to happen. And I said, Bhagavad, what do you think now? He said, I want both. Then I thought, it's impossible. How come it's possible you get a job and at the same time you finish your entire second year? And then, how it happened, I don't know. He joined the ISRO job. He left IIT studies without informing. And then he took leave after 2 months, came and joined the supervisor, continued his M.Tech master's thesis. And within 1 year, he finished his M.Tech degree and he continued the job. There are a lot of incidents happened behind that, and whatever he wished, he could get. And there were, because of time limitations, I'll restrict to just few incidents, maybe if the organizers permit. This is such a momentum, and the more we started getting revelations in mind, our control of complexities, we shared. And there was an incident in Assam, a Muslim girl, she was there in the front row, and we had a discourse on Faguchi, and she was the first person to take the holy mail. And then she messaged me, sir, I took the holy name afterwards, maybe you didn't see. And then when I informed to my parents told, can you imagine the Muslim parents, they would think it's a Hindu religion, because, and they didn't know this is not connected to any religions, caste or creed. Her father told, the first time you made me proud, you took a thing which is going to bring a change in your life. And it continued. I came across with many people with lifetime experiences. I'd say one more, the amount of confidence that you get, and the decision making. We had one Kajuda, many of you know from Assam, and he was assigned a task by Pujane Babaida, that there is the people of Assam wants a train to from Assam to Deoghar.
And the railway budget was already announced. That time the minister was Lalu Prasad Yadavji. And because his master was sent to get the job done, he went with some local MPs. He went and opposed Lalu Yadavji. And you know how strong leader Laluji is. Laluji told, no. The budget is over. Everything is announced. Impossible. And look, because his master has told, the Pujani Bhavad has told, if you love me, you can get the work done. So that much of confidence he was carrying, at that instant, he had a presence of mind. He went and hold Lalu Yadavji's feet and cried, "Nahi churunga, aapko nahi churunga, mere guru ne bheja hai. अगर आप ट्रेन नहीं देंगे तो हम यहाँ से आज नहीं जा सकते हैं. मैं किस तरह मैं मुंह दिखा सकता हूँ. He started crying. Lalu Yadavji uncontrollable. He was uncontrollable. छोड़ो मेरे पांव छोड़ो. कैबिनेट सेक्रेटरी कॉल, उनके लिए कुछ कीजिए, ईश्वर ने उनको भेजा है, कुछ कीजिए. एंड इट वॉज द फर्स्ट टाइम इन द हिस्ट्री आफ्टर द इवन द अनाउंसमेंट वॉज मेड ही वॉज एंड द ट्रेन वॉज अनाउंस्ड. And I was fortunate to be there when the train started from Dibrugarh to Guwahati to Deoghar. So many incidents. And the last incident I would share, when I teach in Japanese universities, we deal with a lot of Japanese students. Look, Japanese are also, they come from different religions, different mindset, their work ethics is completely different. I had, maybe I'll take last 5 minutes. I met with a guy who was working in my host lab. That's the same laboratory in Japan, Oyama. And he was so aggressive, so violent. Every time I approach, because I'm a foreigner, every time I approach him, he said, "You Indian, why you came here? Do you think you get to learn things from us? I'm not going to tell you anything." It was so revolting. I had no idea how to make friendship with him. I said, if I have learned from my Guruji, I can make friends with anyone. But he behaves like an enemy. Then I remember once, Acharya has told, if you have an enemy, you give some offerings. You go and visit his house, something, and in surprise, I invited him for a dinner. I told, I'm preparing Indian curry. Really? You are preparing Indian curry for me? I don't like you. I said, no matter. Still, I would like to offer you. And in the night, he came to my guest house, my room, and he ate. Afterwards, he saw a picture. Thakurji, Acharya's picture, and Pujaniya Bhavaja's picture was there. He said, who is your grandfather? I said, more than my grandfather. Who is he? He's your father? More than my father. Supreme father. And he's my elder brother. I said, what is supreme father? You prove something supreme father? I said, he's living God. Can you prove? If you cannot prove, I'm going to slap you. Because I got to know his father is a Korean. Mother is a Buddhist from Japanese. A Christian, Korean. And the son is so violent. They are divorced, and he's the only child. The aggressiveness in his mind was coming, I could see. I was completely horrified. He said, in next 10 minutes, if you cannot show your living God here, I'm going to kill you. And so aggressive, what I did, I put a white clothes. I said, you sit down here. I'm going to meditate. Really? So he sat down. I also sat in front of me. I started preaching the holy name. I said, today is your day, God. If you don't save me, I'm going to be beaten by him. It's a test for me. It's a test for your existence. And I, 5 minutes over, I could see in between, I saw him close with closed eyes. He's also silent. 10 minutes over, he had given me 5 minutes. 10 minutes over, 15 minutes over, I opened my eyes, he's still sitting quiet. After 20 minutes, he opened his eyes. He said, I could see the same person sitting in front of you and me. And That's the first time I felt the God is living, and He proved He's living, and for everything you ask, there is an answer for you. And the same person, Oyama, became my good friend. He sent an email. Look, Sahoo-sensei, for teacher, Sahoo-sensei, in village, in Japanese village, I saw some the masters feeding. They are very poor in English. He was translating probably in Google. The masters feeding the dogs. The dogs are so happy sitting in the shade of the trees and like that. And he sent a cup, saucer, a gift for me. And I was called by the IIT post office. He got a post for you. And please come and collect. I said, what? No, it has come from Japan. And the name Oyama. Kasunori Oyama. And then what is inside? Some gift. Please collect and pay 10,000 rupees. I said, for what? Because of customs duty and other things. Do you know, I went and opened, it was a small cup, tea cup, and I paid 10,000 because I earned a friend. That's the earning from the. There are so many things, maybe because our esteemed speaker is here, he would give a more brief account of Thakurji. With this, I wish all my friends that they would realize the importance of Holy Name, and you will also succeed in waging war against the conflicts that are arising from your mind. Thank you so much.